in Mai Mai Cojuangco's home, the ancestral home of the Cojuangcos.
I'm really happy. Thank you for having me.
But I need to know more about you being boss lady. I love that term, boss lady.
I love that.
Women who are calling the shots, you know, creating their own content, own companies, and you are one of these women.
There is no boss without the struggle.
Mm.
Yeah, so I think you reach that point or feeling. But mind you, I mean, there's always something wherever you are, boss, not boss, climbing to be that. No one is ever spared from difficulty. But to be boss, it's certainly not without any obstacles. I mean, it's...
And you've like definitely had your fair share. I can tell by you explaining it. Like,
all I can say is living away certainly builds resilience. And I would like to be an inspiration for other women, because you can only become the most full and honest version of yourself after struggle, after difficult times. So you just have to flip. Mm-hmm. And I have to honestly say, and I'm sure a lot of mothers will agree, it becomes even more complicated when you have children in that way, because they don't want to see you crying and sad and all of that. So when they come,
right,
when it's time to work,
it's like switch up, superwoman.
Yeah,
superwoman, supermom.
Like on off switch. Right. Off.
So yeah, with your company, with Demetria.
Yes.
How did this happen? What gravitated you to wanting to enter the industry of bag design?
I believe in destiny, and I believe in timing. And through a friend of my sister, and then my sister at some point, because I wasn't even here, she spoke to my partner right now, my business partner. It's always been a collaboration with Ide. It's a store in Pasong Tamo, and I met this woman who said, let's try. And I was just ripe and ready. Mm. And then it turns out that she goes to Florence very often and all of that. And I was like, oh, okay. Because, you know, I mean, sometimes you just need that push, right? Mm-hmm. Like, let's begin. Let's start. And I was like, okay. And, well, we had the trunk show, the first trunk show last year. We sold out. So I'm like, oh,
yeah. That sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
Well, because some struggle, but some pretty awesome success along your path.
Yeah. And like what I said, you know, maybe there is that thing I'm channeling that I'm not fully conscious of. Because when I told you, create the things you wish existed, I apply that to everything. So I said, for example, there's a bag that I made, because I only have 3 bag styles. Because I said, you know, classics can always be revisited. If you have the right shape, if you have the right size, one day you can do it in leather, the next day you can do it in python. We even did crocodile this time. There's this thing about women carrying a bag and then they don't want to move everything they have in it. So I said, okay, I'm going to do the demi. I called it demi because it was the most difficult in construction, and that's my daughter's name. So I said, yeah, I want a bag like that, you know, that can carry everything. And then if I decide to go out and have something that's not necessarily like super formal but still dressy, I want to make that bag.
I need to get my hands on some of your bags. When we come back, we'll have more Mai Mai musings when we return.